Have you ever struggled to imagine what your lace swatch will look like once you actually apply it to the pattern that you're working with? Because the lace can express very differently when you add the style lines of the garment, the curves of the pattern, where the straight edges are, and it can look very different than what you had originally visualized. And this is where Clo3D offers us a major advantage, because you're actually working with the appropriate scale lace and the appropriate scale pattern on the appropriate scale body, so you can get a really solid perspective on how your garment will turn out before actually cutting into the materials and sewing it up. That's what we're gonna do today. So we're gonna take this garment, and then we're gonna take this lace swatch, and we're gonna turn it into a new lace, which we can bring into Clo3D and apply to this garment to see if we like the look of it or not. And so I'm here to grow and learn and share my knowledge so we can all learn and grow together. Thanks for being here with me. I hope you learned something today. Let's get into it. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is open our image in Photoshop and unlock the background. And if this image has any perspective distortion from your camera, the first step that I do is remove perspective distort. You do that by going to Layer, Smart Object, Convert to Smart Object, and then Filter, Lens Correction, and then under Custom, under Remove Distortion right here, you can slide this slider back and forth and decide if there's any correction that you need to make. But I think this image was actually done with a scan, so I'm just gonna leave it at zero for now, and then I'm gonna select okay. So after we've corrected any perspective distortion, we are going to crop this, but first we need to flatten the layer. So we're going to go flatten image. Okay, and now we are going to crop this. So let's unlock the background again, and then we're gonna use our crop tool. And then we are going to turn it horizontal, And then I'm just gonna look for, so first I'm gonna get rid of any of discoloration. See how it's a little bit yellow right around here? So I'm gonna crop out that. And then I'm gonna start looking for where the repeat happens in the lace. So for example, I have this leaf here, here it repeats again, right here, and here it repeats again. So I'm gonna start at this one here, and then I'm gonna go over to this one here. So I'm looking at the edge of this leaf here, I'm kind of going through the edge of that leaf there, and then I'll look at the top of it. So I have this leaf right here, and then it repeats again right here, and it repeats again over here, right here. So I need to be at the edge of that leaf there. So like that. And then I might straighten it out a little bit like that. And then I just fiddle with this until I see something that's good. Make sure you leave yourself a good amount of room on the top and bottom of your image as well. And then once I'm generally happy with that, I'll press enter. And then I'm going to check the repeat of it. So I'm gonna go filter other, offset, and look for where the repeat happens. Here it is, right here, right here. You can see it right there. So I'm going to press enter, and then enter for the crop, and then to kind of like help that repeat look blended, I'm going to use the clone stamp tool. And I'm going to make it smaller. And we're just going to grab like this here, Alt click, and then replace that there. And then we'll do this area here. So this here, there. And then we'll grab like that and replace that. And then we'll do the same thing around here. Once you think it looks pretty well blended, then we're going to remove the background. We're going to go select color range, and we'll select the black. And then you can decide how much detail you want to preserve. And I usually go pretty high, especially because this has a nice contrast between the black and the white. I pretty much move it all the way up and then select OK and then delete. That's my lace swatch that I'm going to bring into Clo now. So I can save this Photoshop image to come back to it if I need to. And then I'm also going to go file, export, quick export as PNG. Just save it somewhere on your computer. So now when you open your file in Clo, you can add your new fabric in one of three ways. You can either use a fabric that you're already using in Clo. So if I wanted to just replace the visual qualities of this fabric while maintaining the physical properties of the fabric, I would just make a copy of this fabric by selecting the fabric here and then selecting copy, which creates a copy of that fabric, which I can then go in and change the map down here. The other way to add a fabric in Clo would be to use the library. If you wanted to change the physical properties of your fabric for some reason, you can go into the library and pick something that has a similar physical quality to the fabric that you're working with and add that fabric in. Like let's say we wanted this woven cotton. I double click on that. It's added to my object browser here. And then I would just delete the maps that are applied to this fabric so that we can apply the new one that we've just created. So I don't want that. And the third way to create a fabric in Clo is to add a default fabric, which is it came in right here, and then use the fabric creator. So from here, you can give your fabric a name, and then you can come down to fabric type, and then you can select what kind you want here. They actually have a lace fabric in here for you, so you could select lace, and then you could put your exact composition. So if we know it's like a cotton, nylon, spandex mix, we would select those three materials, and then you could put the exact amount of each of those materials in. So if we had like a 6% spandex and a 30% nylon and then a 64% cotton. So if that was the blend, and then if we had like a 50 GSM, you can put your exact properties that you would want for your fabric in there. And then under texture, you would open the seamless lace repeat that we just created. And then you could see it applies that repeat. And then you can also create a normal map now in Clo by just opening up the normal map tab right here. And then turning the slider up, and it creates a normal map for you. And then you can hit apply and close, and you can see that we've created this new fabric here. So I just created this rectangle here, and I'm going to replace that with the new lace. Now we have to apply scale to it. So I know that that lace was originally 23 centimeters wide. So I just create this rectangle and I make sure that it's 23 centimeters. And now I'm going to use the texture editor, and then I'm going to scale this lace down so it fits into that box. If I right click while changing the scale, I can change it by an exact percentage. So I'll try 105% and see how it fits in the box. And then I'm going to come back down to 99%. And now it's fitting in there perfectly. So now I know this lace is appropriate scale. Now I don't really need to create a mirror image of this lace because this lace already is mirrored from top to bottom. But if you do have a lace like the original one that I had here, which was only, I only had one side of it. So I didn't actually have a mirror of this lace. So to create a mirror of it, I just took that original lace. I made a copy of it. So this is the copy here. So this swatch is my original, and this swatch, we are going to mirror that. And to do that, we're going to use the texture editor right click and then flipped horizontally. And now you can see if I turn these this way, it'll be more clear. Now you can see this pattern piece is the original lace here, and this pattern piece is the mirrored lace. So I'm just gonna delete that because I don't need it. So in Clo, I don't have to make a repeat of this lace, but I like to do it because the top and bottom of this lace, it's hard to get them perfectly symmetrical. So I find it easier just to create a mirror of this lace as well. So this, we'll call it new lace, and then we'll make a copy of it. And we'll call this new lace mirror. And then I'm gonna make a copy of this pattern piece. And I'm going to add the new lace mirror fabric to this piece. I'm gonna use the texture editor, right click and flip texture horizontally. So now this one is a mirror of the original. Okay, so once we have our fabrics created, we can apply them piece by piece. Like I could apply this one here, and then I could apply this one, the mirrored lace here, and then go around all my pattern pieces and then use the texture editor to make sure that they are aligned the way I want them to. But the more useful thing to do would be to go to production colorway, add a new colorway, and then we're just gonna go through and apply the new lace to all the pattern pieces that we need. So I'm going to select this front cup and this one. And this one, and I'm going to apply this new lace to it. And then this one, oops. Oh wait, that should be new lace as well. And then on this side, I'm going to apply all the mirrored laces. And then now we'll go through with the texture editor and make sure that the lace is lined up as we want it to be. So, and then you can hit update. And there you go. There's your new lace applied. So I think that's really pretty. One thing that I might want to play with is let's say I want this lace to look a little more white. I can select the lace and then come down to desaturate and switch. And I can decide if I like the look of desaturate or switch better. We can check out in the render what we think as well. And so we can decide if we like the look of desaturate better or switch better. I think I like desaturate if I didn't want to see these gray areas. You could also play with shadow intensity here. And you could also turn on the normal map here, which will give you a little bit more dimension in the lace. That's right here. You just have to turn up this slider. So kind of like the look of that. So I would just make sure that I apply those properties. So we have desaturate with a shadow intensity of minus 32 and a normal map of 23. Then I would apply it to the other side. So I would have desaturate with a, what did I say? Minus 32 and an intensity in a normal map of 23. So now those properties would be applied to the whole garment, and that looks really cool. And one more thing I'll leave you with is, because this is really cool, if you want to change the color of this lace now, like let's say we wanted to see what it looked like in a red, you could do that from here. So I think it's really cool. Clo gives you all kinds of options to be able to really dial in and visualize exactly how you want your garment to to look before you actually go in and use your materials. So that's it for today. If you found this kind of information useful, you might want to check out my course, Clo3D Foundations for Intimate Apparel. It's actually closed right now because I am updating the content for Clo 2024, but you can sign up below and get on my waitlist to find out more about it. Thanks for being here. I hope you learned something, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.